In this activity, we're told to use a rectangular bar as our unit or as one whole. Number one, represent the fraction 2/3. So if this bar represents one whole, because the denominator is 3, we would cut the bar into 3 equally sized pieces or parts. And then because the numerator is 2, we're considering 2 of the 3 equally sized parts or pieces. And therefore, we shade 2 of the 3 parts or pieces. And therefore, this is a model to represent the fraction 2/3. Number 2, draw a picture to visualize 6 copies of 2/3. Well, this model is 1 copy of 2/3, and therefore it would take 6 of these to model 6 copies of 2/3. So this would be a model for 6 copies of 2/3. Number 3, how many copies of 1/3 are shaded? Well, every model of 2/3 is 2 copies of 1/3, and therefore there are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 copies of 1/3 shaded. Next, we're asked to name the value of the shaded region in more than one way. Well, because we have 12 copies of 1/3, one way to express the value would be to say the value is 12/3. Because the denominator is 3, we know it takes 3 parts to make one whole, and because we have 12 parts, 12/3 is equal to 4. A fraction bar also means division. Notice 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. But to better visualize why this equals 4, let's look at another model. If we begin with 6 copies of 2/3, which you know is also 12 copies of 1/3, and we reassemble these parts into bars, notice how these 12 parts, or these 12 copies of 1/3, make exactly 4 bars, showing the value is equal to 4. And then finally for number 4, we're asked to write a multiplication sentence illustrated by the picture. Well, 6 copies of 2/3 means 6 times 2/3, which we know is equal to 12/3, which is equal to 4. Here's a multiplication sentence or multiplication equation illustrated by the picture of 6 copies of 2/3. I hope you found this helpful.